You brought this brilliantly up in the movie, the hypocritical posture of all this. And let me ask you this, in the same sense, we know, well, let's be honest, you know, and all these athletic arenas, I mean, how many guys are using A, and B, how many teams probably know it but turn their head because they know these athletes bring in the money? They know that this great football player, if he's on that field, people are going to come and pay to watch him play, or a basketball player, or whatever, maybe a track star. So talk a little bit about, you know, how do you feel? Do you think, what percentage do you think really are clean? I mean, just guessing, obviously.
You know, it's interesting. We were just talking about, off the air, the Ultimate Fighting Championship.
Exactly.
And I love the UFC. It's my favorite thing in the world to watch. It's my favorite sport by far. And Brock Lesnar, there's an interview with Brock Lesnar where he gets accused of using anabolic steroids. Well, they just ask him, you're a pretty big guy. And before they can even say anything, he rips the microphone off and he says, this interview's over. I know what you're going to ask me. And then he's yelling and he's like, I don't take that stuff. I've never failed a drug test, blah, blah, blah.
Wow.
And so, like, I don't know what drug test he's ever had, first of all. But the flip side of it, the guy's 280 pounds and ripped, right?
Exactly.
And I'm not accusing him of anything, but I'm just saying that, like, if he had done it, it would be something that, you know, would be fine for him to talk about, because he's not saying, oh, I used it to, you know, beat Randy Couture, but, you know, he could have used it in the past or whatever. The guy was just asking a simple question. But
sure,
it just goes to show you that, like, so then they interview, we'll get into the owners and things like that. They interview Dana White, who runs the Ultimate Fighting Championship.
Right.
He's the president of the organization. And he said, you'd have to be an idiot to use anabolic steroids in this day and age. And I'm thinking, you know, come on. I'm like, they don't have any off-season testing.
Right.
They test, you know, right after the fight. So if you were on steroids, you know, if you could train for 6 months on steroids, go off them for a month and pass a drug test easy.
Exactly.
So, I mean, I don't know where they're getting at, like, oh, you know, you'd be stupid to use them. You'd be stupid not to use them.
Exactly.
You know, you're in a sport where people are trying to bash your head in.
Right.
And so, you know, when you look at those things, those are the questions that need to be asked. And
sure.
No, you know, none of the reporters know enough about it to even ask those questions. That's why I made this movie, because I was going to be the journalist that was going to ask the right questions to the right people. You know, and the other thing, a quick other note, is that, you know, with the owners, president, or, you know, our favorite American president, George Bush, was the owner of the Texas Rangers. And when he was the owner of the Texas Rangers, Jose Canseco was on his team. And we document all this stuff in the movie. You know, I say, you know, did the president know that his players were on the juice? Well, what do you think? I mean, Jose Canseco is openly talking about it to everybody in the locker room at the time.
Right.
Do you think maybe that, you know, he knew? I would assume so.
Right.
And when I asked Henry Waxman, I said, this wasn't in the movie, but I asked him, I said, why didn't you call George Bush into the hearings? And he said, well, you know, he's got other better, bigger things to
do.
And I said, well, if he's got bigger things to do, don't you guys have bigger things to do? Aren't we in a war? You know, didn't we just have Hurricane Katrina at the time?
Right.
You know, don't we have a problem with national health care?
Right.
All these other things that they spent 7 days on anabolic steroids in sports. That's more time than all those other things I just listed.
Wow.
That the oversight committee spent, you know,
right,
on just trying to scrutinize athletes. And the one thing was, it was a circus. I mean, it was a media circus. Anytime you can get the media involved, you know, people jump on the bandwagon. And, you know, I just think it's interesting. It's like, you know, I asked them, for example, Mickey Rourke, who's, you know, a great actor, just did this movie,
The Wrestler.
He looks amazing.
Right.
There's all this talk going around about, you know, whether or not Mickey did steroids for the role and blah, 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 you know. And he's huge and he's ripped, you know. So, and again, like, I'm not accusing him of anything. He's an awesome actor. He's a great guy. The thing is that we want to give him an Oscar.
Right.
Right?
Exactly.
For his performance, yet everybody's speculating that he's juiced.
Right.
So we speculate that Barry Bonds was juiced.
That's right.
With no evidence, and we want to take all his records away. So when I asked Henry Waxman, I said, why don't you test actors? Because aren't actors a bigger influence on kids than professional athletes? Don't kids go, you know, kids go to movies, and if they look at Rambo or, and he's like, oh, well, you know, we don't, that's just going too far. And I'm like, it's not going too far.
Exactly.
If you're going to test somebody, test everybody, which goes into testing high school kids. Are you going to test high school kids for anabolic steroids, but not test the kids that are smoking pot in the marching band?
Exactly.
I mean, why are you going to single out athletes? So, you know, I just say, like, let's not be hypocritical. Let's ask the right questions. Let's approach this in a smart manner.
Right. There seems to be, like, almost like you said in the movie, too, there's like a closed door policy. As soon as that word comes up, everything stops. You made the great analogous with Heath Ledger. And if he had gone down, if he had died because of steroids of some sort, it would have been all over the news. It would have been blown out of proportion. But yeah, it was Xynex basically overdosed with some prescription pills, and nothing was really said, and it was very sad.
No one's like, let's ban Xanax.
Exactly.
Let's ban. You know, we have all these guys that have died from drug overdoses, from prescription drugs, and nobody questions it. But as soon as Chris Benoit kills his whole family, well, they found all the same drugs that were in Heath Ledger's body in Chris Benoit's house. The
right.
only difference was Chris Benoit looked like a bodybuilder. He
right.
was ripped. You know, he's a professional wrestler. And, you know, they immediately blame steroids. What they didn't even mention, really, is the guy had 16 concussions
exactly.
over the course of his career. His finishing move, he would climb to the top rope, jump off, and land on the guy with a headbutt.
Right.
You think that's maybe going to rattle your brain a little bit? And,
yeah.
you know, the other thing is they found bottles of alcohol at his feet, you know, like a empty bottle of wine and like an empty 12-pack of beer.
Right.
And they didn't mention that, which is legal. They didn't,
wow.
you know, could possibly maybe somebody get drunk and go on a rampage.
Right.
In my life, I basically have worked as a bouncer to pay the bills and get through college. I worked at the school bar at USC, the 9-0. I've worked at Sharky's in Hermosa Beach. And
sure.
I was a manager of security there. And I never threw anybody out for roid rage, but I could tell you I threw hundreds of people out for beer rage.
There you go.
And so when you want to talk, oh, it makes you aggressive, blah, blah, doesn't beer make people aggressive?
Exactly.
You know, speaking of which, Super Bowl Sunday, I think, is the number one
violent crime or domestic
wife beating
yeah, exactly.
Holiday, which
exactly.
is, you know, and it's due to alcohol.